Hello, my name is Dana Olfis. I'm a literacy coach here for Prince George's County Public Schools. Today, I'll be reading the book, Sarah Sidney's Runaway Adventure. Our book will be interpreted today by Karen Bowers, a teacher at Duval High School. The book is written by Pam Schiller and illustrated by Joe Buddy. And today we have two main characters, Miss Kravitz, and her sign name is? And we also have Sarah Sidney. She's a lizard, and her sign name is? Sarah Sidney's owner scheduled a trip, so she called Miss Kravitz to come pet sit. She showed Miss Kravitz how to prepare Sarah's food and how to understand her iguana's moods. She explained the importance of a daily outing and warned Miss Kravitz that Sarah didn't like shouting. "You must never," she said, "whatever you do, take Sarah outside at 2:30. Sarah's owner left the next day, and Miss Kravitz came to stay. She had no trouble fixing Sarah Sidney's foods or reading her funny iguana moves. But when it came to Sarah's walk, Miss Kravitz had a mental block. "Do we go for our walk at 2:30? Or do we never walk at 2:30? Miss Kravitz just couldn't recollect what Sarah's owner said in that respect. So she got Sarah ready, and out the door they flew, just as the clock struck 2:30. At the very same time, out of his door, with a clang, came the neighbor next door, Mr. Bojang. And at the same time, there was even more noise as the school bus arrived, bringing home girls and boys. Sarah Sidney startled and then went berserk, and Miss Kravitz tumbled down when the leash gave a jerk. The children gave chase, as did Mr. Bojang, but Sarah ran faster away from the gang. She ran through the park and through the stoplight. She ran so fast, she was soon out of sight. She found a quiet place under some thicket where she listened to the song of a happy cricket. The cheerful notes of the cricket's serenade helped Sarah calm down. She was no longer afraid. She thanked her new friend for his cheerful song and headed home feeling happy and strong. Miss Kravitz was searching all around with concern. My heart skipped a beat with Sarah's return. "Oh my," she exclaimed, "I'm so glad you're back. You almost gave me a heart attack." She took Sarah's leash and led her inside and said out loud with a great deal of pride, "I have learned my lesson through and through. We will never go for a walk at 2:30. The end. Have a great summer, everyone, and don't forget to read. No.